This is a 0.36 inch LED 7 segment display with TM1637, and there is another version, 0.56 inch version. Once I received this, this was not working. I'm going to show you how to fix it by removing some component and changing with this. I will also provide you the code that you can run and test it, and it will work perfectly. You can get the code for this by clicking at the link below the video in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. So we have this module that's perfectly working with the same code, but there is another module, this larger one. And this is, if we connect it, you will see that we will have the power. So you see that we have the power, but this is not showing any data even if I reset it. And then these two pins could be wrong. So let's connected, and that's a problem. As you see here, these are the two resistors. It says 103, 103. This is 10, and 3 is 30. So it's 10 kilo ohm resistor. This version, this even does not turn on, and the power will not show off. But this one, this has the power. Let me disconnect it. But this one, the power will turn on. But as you can see here, the capacitors are on this side and the resistors are on the other side. So they have incorrectly, if I put them side by side, you will see that they put the resistors, two resistors here. This is a power LED, and here they put two capacitors, the one that doesn't have any label, yellowish color. So this is the incorrect one. These supposed to be capacitor. So, and also, in order for this to work, we have to remove these two capacitors. So what I will do is I will remove these resistors here and remove the capacitor. Here I'm going to show you how to remove these two resistors and move them there. First, you need a very sharp tip. Just to remove it, put the soldering iron on one side, and on the other side you give it a little heat. So this way it will heat up, and that is removed. This piece is done. Now let's remove the other one. So let me put this aside. So the other piece is removed in there with the tweezer. And once you put it, hold it, the tweezer at the spot, and just bring the tip off the soldering iron. Now let me do the second one in the same spot. That is done. I will turn it on this side so I can apply solder on this side of the resistor. This time I'm just gonna hold it from the top and put the soldering iron, and that's enough. Now I'm going to remove these two capacitors from here. Apply a little, and apply more here on this side and on this side, and that's it. And as you can see, the two capacitors have been removed. And there are two resistors of 10 kilo ohm in here. And here, after removing those capacitors and putting the resistors on this side, this is working perfectly. And this is the other one. The one with the power. This is also working. And here is a small one. And here the small one, is also working perfectly with the same code. The method that I've shown you works with this module that has the resistor and capacitors on this side and chip is at the middle. But I've seen also on AliExpress and eBay the chips, the module sold like this, which the chip is on this side and there are no resistor and capacitor. They have been aligned in here and two in here. I have no idea about this, if that applies to this or not, but definitely applies to this type of module. Thank you for watching. This was how to solve the issue of one of these modules that is sold on eBay, AliExpress or Amazon. If you like and learn something from this video, please thumb up. Please subscribe so you can get updates of my upcoming videos. If you have comments or questions, please post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply.